Then let's go back to the problem which we had left off. I think it was on board number 22. Yeah, this guy. Now give it a try. So here the idea is, if you want the equation of a projection, we first need to know what is the point of intersection. Okay, that we can find out easily. And we have been also, yeah, and we have been also indirectly given that the point 1, minus 1 and 3 lies on this. So you find the image of this here. So once your P and Q are known, you can always write down the equation of the line connecting P and Q. That's the whole agenda. Got it. So see, what is my requirement here? My requirement is the equation of this line of projection. So I'll first find out P. Then I'll find out Q. Then I'll find out the line connecting P and Q. Okay. So how will I find P? How will I find Q? That I'll leave up to you. So please do it and tell me the answer. I'm waiting.
So I got the answer in Cartesian form.
That's fine. What's the answer?
So I got x minus 9 by 2 by 2 is equal to y minus 11 by 4 by minus 1 is equal to z minus 10 by 4.
Okay. Anybody else? Okay, so let me take this up quickly. So for finding P, we'll assume that P corresponds to some lambda parameter. So let's say the parameter corresponding to P is lambda. So let me take it as lambda. So I can write down the coordinates of P as 2 lambda plus 1 comma minus lambda minus 1 comma 4 lambda plus 3. Okay, now this must satisfy pi. This must lie on this plane pi. So I can say 2 lambda plus 1 plus 2 times minus lambda minus 1 plus 4 lambda plus 3 is equal to 9. Cool. So let me solve for lambda. I think 2 lambda will get cancelled. So it will be 4 lambda. And you have a 3 plus 1, which is 4. 4 minus 2 is 2, is equal to 9. So lambda is 7 by 9. 7 by 4, sorry. Correct?
Yes, 7 by 4.
7 by 4. So the point P here would be 7 by 2 plus 1, which is 9 by 2. Okay. Minus lambda minus 1 will be minus 11 by 4. And 4 lambda plus 1 will be 10.
Yes.
How would I find Q? Q can be found out by using the formula which I just now told you, but not to be used in school. So let's say Q is X2, Y2, Z2. So X2 minus 1 by 1, Y2 plus 1 by 2, and Z2 minus 3 by 1 is negative. Put this point over here, you get 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 9 by A square, B square, C square, A square, B square, C square. Okay. So we have X2 minus 1 by 1 is equal to Y2 plus 1 by 2 is equal to Z2 minus 3 by 1. And this will give you minus 11 plus 4. So 7 by 6. Correct. So X2 is equal to 13 by 6. Right? Y2 is equal to 7 by 3 minus 1, 4 by 3. And Z2 will be 25 by 6. Am I correct? Clear? So this is your point Q. So once you know the two points P and Q, and you have to write down the equation of a line passing through them, that's very simple. You can say X minus 9 by 2, Y plus 11 by 4, Z minus 10, and divide it by the difference of these two points. So 27 by 6 minus this will be 27 by 6. That's 9 by 2, by the way. Minus 13 by 6. That's going to be 14 by 6. 14 by 6 is 7 by 3. Okay. Then subtract these two. Minus 11 by 4 minus 4 by 3. So minus 33 minus 16. Minus 49 by 12. Correct. And finally, 10 minus 25 by 6. That's 35 by 6. Is that fine? I don't think so. You got the same answer, Aditya.
So my direction ratios were not correct.
Okay. It's so you need to do one thing. You can multiply this with 12, 12, 12 in the denominator also. Okay. And you can put your answer as this. X minus 9 by 2 by 28. Y plus 11 by 4 by minus 49. And Z minus 10 by 70. Okay. And the good thing is you can drop the 7 factor. So X minus 9 by 2 by 4 is Y plus 11 by 4 by minus 7 is equal to Z minus 10 by 10. Okay. And you can further simplify by multiplying by 4 in the numerator. Anyways, now there's another way to deal with this problem. Can I get the equation of a plane which contains this line? Can I get this plane equation which contains this line? Guys, so can I get a plane which is containing this line and perpendicular to this plane? See, what I'm trying to do is, see my intentions. My intention is to get a plane. So this was the line, right, whose projection we needed. So if I make a plane which is containing this line, correct, and which is perpendicular to it. So can I say the projection line will be nothing but a line of intersection of this plane, pi1 and pi2 plane. Can I do it like this also? Let me know if you agree with what I'm saying. See, consider a plane which is perpendicular to pi1 and containing the given line to you. Can I say the combined equation of pi1 and pi2 will give you the asymmetric form of the line of intersection, which is nothing but the projection line?
Yes, sir.
Guys, yes, no, maybe.
Yes, sir.
Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, can you get a plane which is perpendicular to this and containing this line? Yes or no? Once you get that plane, just write down this plane and the other plane that you get as an asymmetric form. That will give you the equation of the projection of the line. From there, you can convert it to symmetric form. That's your call. Is that fine? Will you do that as homework and send it to me on WhatsApp? So here, yes, my question was, get a plane which contains X minus 1 by 2, Y plus 1 by minus 1, and Z minus 3 by 4, and perpendicular to X plus 2, Y plus Z equal to 9. Okay, once you get this plane, then this plane and the other plane that you get would be the asymmetric form, will form the asymmetric form for the equation of the projection line. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Next concept that we'll take up is the concept of angle between a line and a plane. So let's say there is a plane here and there is a line like this, which is passing through the plane. So the angle between the line and the plane is basically defined as the angle between the line and its projection. And its projection on the given plane. Okay. By the way, finding projection is difficult. That's why we also say that it's complementary of the angle between the normal to the plane and the line. So this will become your 90 minus theta. That's an easy way to look at the same scenario. Okay. So you can say that it is also the complementary. Of the angle between the line and the normal to the plane. Getting this? So let's say this line equation is R equal to A1 plus lambda B1. Okay. And this plane equation is R dot N plus D equal to zero. So can I say the angle could be found out by using the formula dot product, that is cos of 90 minus theta. Okay. And if you want the acute angle, it will be mod of N dot B1 by mod N mod B1. Okay, please note, it will now give you sine of the angle. Okay, so don't forget, here sine will come. When you are finding the angle between a line and a plane, your theta would be sine inverse of this. However, you are using the dot product itself, but here, because your theta here is a complementary of the required theta, that's why a sine will come. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
CLR, sir.
CLR. Okay. Can we have a quick problem on this? Let's take. This is plus here.
Done, sir.
Done. What is the answer?
The sine inverse 4/3.
Sine inverse
4/3√2.
Okay, good.
That's yes, correct.
That's correct. So your sine of theta would be, this is what we need. These two are the things which we are concerned with, this and this. So dot product of it will be what? 2 plus 1 plus 1 by under root of, this is going to be root 6 and this is going to be root 3.
Root 3.
Okay. So 4 by, this is root 2 into root 3, root 3. Which is nothing but 4/3√2. So theta is sine inverse of 4/3√2. Fine?
Yes, sir.
Let's take more questions. Yeah, this problem. This is based on family of planes. Read the question carefully. There's a plane AX plus BY equal to 0 and it is rotated through an angle of alpha about its line of intersection with the plane Z equal to 0. Show that the equation of the plane in the new positions is given by, so there will be two answers. So that's why there is a plus and minus in the answer. How do I do this?
So can we find the point where it intersects like the...
No need. You can use family of planes for this. See it. The situation is there was this plane, AX plus BY equal to 0 plane, and there is Z equal to 0 plane. Okay. Now through the line of intersection, which is this line, okay, this plane pi 1 is given a twist of alpha. It can be in both directions. It can be up also, it can be down also alpha. So let's say I reach a new position here. Okay, I want the equation of this guy. Now you can all see that the yellow planes and the white plane, they all form a family member, isn't it? So can I say let the required plane will have the equation, let the required plane have this equation, AX plus BY plus lambda Z equal to 0, yes or no? Now, in order to find the value of lambda, I can use the fact that the angle between these two planes here is alpha, correct? And you already know how to find the angle between two planes when you know the know their equations, isn't it? A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 by under root A1 square B1 square C1 square under root A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. So I can say cos alpha. Okay. Now this equation was AX plus BY equal to 0. Or you can say 0 Z equal to 0. So A1 A2 will be A square, B1 B2 will be B square by under root of A square plus B square under root of A square plus B square plus lambda square. Okay. Now this you can cancel off and write a root over here, square both the sides. So when you square both the sides, you get cos square alpha is equal to A square B square by A square plus B square plus lambda square. Reciprocate it. So A square plus B square plus lambda square by A square plus B square is equal to secant square. Correct. So you can write this as 1 plus lambda square by A square plus B square is secant square. Send this one to the other side. So lambda square A square plus B square is equal to secant square alpha minus 1, which is tan square alpha. So from here it implies lambda could be written as, or lambda square could be written as A square plus B square tan square alpha. Correct. So lambda could be written as plus minus under root A square plus B square tan alpha. Correct. Just put this in place of lambda over here. So when you put the lambda value, you end up getting AX plus BY. Okay. Plus minus under root A square plus B square tan alpha equal to 0. This is what was given to us. Hence proved. Is the idea clear? This question has come so many times. It has come so many times in competitive exams. The same question. Clear, everyone?